This film is going to examine some of the ways, large and small, direct and indirect, obvious and not so obvious, in which railways in Britain are contributing to the conservation of a good social environment. The conversion of part of the former Somerset and Dorset Railway into a nature trail is the start of what might become a general movement all over the country by local authorities to develop greenways for rambling, field study centres and recreational areas, all from disused railway properties which had outlived their purpose and might otherwise have been left derelict or turned to less imaginative use. The City of Bath Boys School started this project as their contribution to Conservation Year. It has also captured the interest of other Bath school children. Plant and wildlife on railway embankments, always prolific, now gets a thorough examination. A section of line was sold at Clipsham in Rutland as a training ground for racehorses. A disused railway station, Widmerpool, on the Nottingham and Melton Mowbray line has been turned into a restaurant, making a congenial use of railway architecture. Norfolk. Wolferton Station was for generations the royal alighting point for the Sandringham estate. Now a home, tastefully converted and retaining the original wood panelling and much of the period feeling of those historical days. An example of the reuse of earlier railway property is the roundhouse at Chalk Farm. Now this fine piece of 19th century engineering echoes to the sound of music and drama. It has become a symbolic social gathering point of today's London. All right now, yeah! A 120 years ago, engines used to be housed here for the London and Northwestern railways. The place echoed to the hiss of steam and the clank and clatter of the iron horse. Let us hope that for some future generation, today's sounds may be equally nostalgic. British Railways architecture in the beginning was comparable in boldness with that of the church. It sprang from an age of craftsmanship and Victorian self-righteousness. Today, its technical exuberance seems particularly impressive against the uncertainties of our contemporary taste. St. Pancras, with its huge single-span arch, conserves this spirit of the early railways. Thank you. There are examples of contemporary railway architecture, on the other hand, which seem successfully to link the modern technological world with the history and traditions that gave it birth. The eastern region of British Railways has, in the interests of decentralisation from London, built Hudson House in York. See how it relates to that ancient city, making sure that the city walls still dominate the scene, and yet reminding us that the electronic age does not grow illogically from them. Stations, whether they are old or new, are part of our daily life. Corporate design and traditional styles go hand in hand. And often, railway buildings make at once a comment on and a contribution to the character of their surroundings. Let us look for a moment at some examples. To preserve our social environment is vital, but technology can also help to conserve man's individual environment. British Rail's computers, as elegant as their function, are taking over with a beautiful precision the elimination and streamlining of elementary paperwork, so that staff can do the work of men and leave the drudgery to the machines. They're better at it and seem to enjoy it. Gone are the days of the footplate. Today's driver has a comfortable cab. Rightly so, too, for it's not only the travelling public who should benefit from the modernisation of the railway environment. In so many departments today, the amenities have improved. The tendency is towards good-looking, well-lit surroundings, making the work more agreeable. Thank you. The British Transport Staff College, Woking, is a centre for up-and-coming and senior managers from all facets of the transport industry. They come, often from abroad too, to study the changing world of management. The setting provides a reassuring springboard for new thinking. Some of British Rail's new equipment could be said to take functional design beyond its industrial uses into an artist's world of coloured shapes moving to form satisfying abstract patterns. The Central Electricity Generating Board and British Rail are combining in a unique project to transform industrial eyesores into agricultural land. Pulverized fuel ash is carried in specially modified press flow rail wagons from the power stations to an area of disused clay pits just south of Peterborough, that is, to the eyesore, a legacy of the local brickworks. The fuel ash is discharged from the railhead through a complex of piping to provide soil for the scarred landscape. Where clay was cut, crops and pasture will grow again. Rail transport, by providing fast intercity and frequent commuter services, can conserve our countryside. By enabling people to move easily and economically of space, it reduces the necessity for creeping urban development in the big cities. We are all increasingly aware of the effect of certain means of transport on our environment in this ever more crowded island. British industry, with railways playing a leading part, is addressing itself to the problem of maintaining the environment in which we live. It has a duty to the community to do so. It can be said that the railway industry has perhaps more than most been able to build its future through looking over its shoulder at the past. The tradition of railway building and design goes back even further than the roundhouse, and over 1.5 centuries it has, more often than not, contributed responsibly to the quality of life. Thank you.